स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ फिजिक्स, दैट इज ऑप्टिक्स। सो व्हाट इज ऑप्टिक्स? सो ऑप्टिक्स इज द ब्रांच ऑफ फिजिक्स दैट डील्स विद द स्टडी ऑफ लाइट एंड इट्स फेनोमेना। ओके, सो ऑप्टिक्स इट इज द ब्रांच ऑफ फिजिक्स that deals with the study of light and its phenomena। Okay, clear? So the branch of physics that deals with the study of light and its phenomena is known as optics। So what is light? So light, it is a form of energy which gives the sensation of vision okay। So the energy form which gives us the sensation of vision is known as light। So we will deal with the study of this light and its phenomena। Clear? So the complete optics is again divided into two parts। So the total optics is divided into two parts। One is ray optics, or it's also known as geometrical optics, and the other one is physical optics। Okay, so what is ray optics? It deals with the rectilinear propagation of light of light। That means light travels in a straight line। In a form of ray or straight line। Okay, again it deals with the macroscopic level study of light। So in geometrical optics or ray optics, we deals with the rectilinear propagation, or we have to assume that the light travel in form of a ray or in form of a straight line। And in geometrical optics, we have to deals with the macroscopic level study of the light। That means we have to deal with the light in macroscopic level or in large format, okay, or in the dimension of the light will be large in the study of geometrical optics। Again, what are the phenomena we have to deal with in geometrical optics? The phenomena of light like reflection, refraction, okay, reflection, refraction are basically the two phenomena that we have to deal in the geometrical optics, the branch of optics। And what is physical optics? It deals with the dual nature of light, okay। So the branch of optics which is known as the physical optics deals with the dual nature of light। What is the dual nature of light? According to physical optics, light behaves
as a wave and also light can behave as a particle. Okay, so the dual nature of light is light behave as a wave and also light can behave as a particle. So this the study of light in form of a wave or in form of a particle comes under the branch physical optics. So again it deals with the study of light in microscopic level. It deals with the study of light in microscopic level. That means here the dimension of light is very negligible or can be comparable with the wavelength of the light. So as we already studied here that light can behave as a wave. So what kind of wave is light? It's an electromagnetic wave. Okay, so you have to remember that. So light is an electromagnetic wave. We will study about it in the wave optics or physical optics. So in physical optics we have to deal with the dual nature of the light, where light can be treated as a wave, that is known as wave optics, and also light can be treated as a particle. So what are the phenomena we have to deal in the physical optics? So the phenomena is like interference, diffraction, polarization. Okay, basically these are the phenomena that we have to deal with the wave optics, which comes under what? Physical optics. And some phenomena like photoelectric effect, Zeeman effect, and Compton effect. These are some phenomena that will study the particle nature of light. Okay, so in physical optics we have to deal with some phenomena like interference, diffraction, polarization are some phenomena which link to the wave nature of light, and photoelectric effect, Zeeman effect or Compton effect are some phenomena which link with the particle nature of light. So complete optics is divided into these two parts. One is ray optics or gemmotical optics, another one is physical optics. And again the physical optics divided into two parts. One is wave optics, another one is particle nature of the light, or it basically deals with the dual nature of light. So when we study light in macroscopic level, we have to deal with the ray optics or gemmotical optics, which basically prefer light as a ray or the rectilinear propagation of light. And when we deal with the physical optics, we have to deal with the light as a wave or as a particle. Clear? So today we are going to discuss about the ray optics or gemmotrical optics. So here we have to deal only with the macroscopic level study of light, or we have to assume that the light travel in a straight line or in form of a ray. Okay. So today we are going to discuss about gemmotrical optics. Okay, so in gemmotrical optics we have to remember one thing, it deals with rectilinear propagation. Okay, rectilinear propagation of light, that means light is traveling in straight line or in form of rays. Light represents in form of as rays. Okay, so what is ray? It's a straight line which
have an arrow mark. Along the direction of propagation of light. Okay, like if here is a source of light which emits light rays, so what is ray? The ray of light is a straight line which travels, have an arrow mark along the direction of propagation of light. So if from this point the light travels along this direction, so this is the direction of propagation of light. So the light can be represented as a ray which is a straight line and has an arrow mark along the direction of propagation of light. If I want to represent a light along this direction, ray of light along this direction, so you have to put a straight line along this direction with an arrow mark along the direction of propagation of light. Clear? So ray is a straight line which have an arrow mark along the direction of propagation of light. So if we are representing the light in form of ray, then that comes under what? Geometrical optics or ray optics. Clear? Then what is a beam? So beam is a combination of large number of rays. Okay, that means this is a light ray. What if there are large number of rays? This is a light beam. Okay, so a combination of large number of rays is known as light beam, and a single straight line with an arrow mark is known as a light ray. In practical case, an isolated light ray is not possible. Generally, light exists in form of light beams. Okay, but in theoretical purpose, we can use a single straight line with an arrow mark as a light ray. But in case of practical purpose, there is never possible to consider an isolated light ray. Generally, light exists in form of light beam. Clear? But in our theoretical purpose, when we derive some derivations in the geometrical optics, we have to assume light as a ray or a single straight line as a ray. Okay. So depending upon the optical instruments, the light rays can be divided into two parts. Okay. So if the optical instruments like mirror, lens, or any object which is behave as an optical object or instrument, the light rays are basically divided into two parts. That means if I am considering a simple, or before that we have to discuss some terms relating to the geometrical optics. Okay, so what is a source? So source is a point which emits light. So source, it is a device which emits light. Okay, so it can be of two types, like self luminous and illuminous. What is self luminous? The source which have light of its own, light of its own, like sun or electric ball. Okay, illuminous, the source which don't possess light of its own, like moon, wall, or paper. Okay, these are the devices which don't have light of its own, but they can reflect light from any other object which emits light. So these are known as illuminous source. And the source which have light of their own, like sun, electric ball, they are known as self-luminous source. Okay, or in geometrical optics,
Next we have to deal with the medium. What is medium? It is the region through which light rays travels. Okay, so the region through which light rays travels is known as medium. And again, medium are of three types. One is transparent, another one is opaque, then third one is translucent. Okay, what is transparent? The medium in which light travels freely. In which light travels freely. And opaque, light can't travel. And here in translucent, light travels partially. Okay, so if in the medium light travels freely, it is known as transparent. If light can't travel, it is known as opaque. If light travels partially, it is known as translucent. So transparent medium example like water or glass. Okay, opaque medium like wall or mirror, and translucent like oil paper. Okay, so these are the different categories of medium. That's what we are going to deal in the ray optics. So you already know what is ray optics, what is source, what is medium, then what is a ray, what is a beam. Okay, so next we have to study about different types of beams. So what are the different types of beams? The different types of beams. Okay, so all the beams are categorized into different types. One is convergent, okay, so next we are going to discuss about types of beams. So first, converging beam. So if the diameter of beam is decreases along the direction of propagation of wave, light, then it is called converging beam. That means if the beams are like this, so here the diameter is large, here the diameter is small, and the direction of propagation of light is along this direction. So if the diameter of the beam is decreasing along the direction of propagation of light, then that is known as a converging beam. Clear? Similarly, what is diverging beam? Diverging beam. If the diameter of the beam increases along direction of propagation of light,
then it is diverging. So if the light rays are like this, the diameter is increasing along the direction of propagation of light. Here the diameter is small, but here the diameter is large, and the direction of propagation of light is along this direction. So these are known as what? Diverging beam. Again, parallel beam, if the diameter of the beam remain constant throughout the propagation of light, then these are known as parallel beam. So like this, so these are known as parallel beam. Okay, so beam are divided into three parts or three categories. Diverging beam, if the diameter of the beam increases along the direction of propagation. Then parallel beam, if the diameter throughout the propagation remain constant. And then converging beam, if the diameter goes on decreasing along the direction of propagation. Clear? Then we have to deal with. What is reflection? If there is a boundary which divided two mediums, this is medium 1 and this is medium 2, and when light ray incident on this surface, okay, this is incident ray, okay. So from this boundary which separate the two medium, medium 1 and medium 2, some part of this incident light ray gets transmitted to the medium 2 and some part of the light gets bounced back along the same medium 1. Okay. Let this be the normal at this point of incident O. So the ray, this is known as incident ray, and the light which goes back to the same medium 1 is known as reflected ray. And the light ray which transmitted to the medium 2 is known as refracted ray. So whenever light incident on a medium which separates two medium, an incident on a boundary which separates two medium, some portion of the light may get transmitted to the other medium and some portion of the light may get reflected to the same medium. So when the light get reflected to the same medium, the light ray is known as reflected ray, and when the light transmitted to the other medium is known as refracted ray. And the phenomena due to which the light return back to the same medium after striking this boundary is known as reflection. So this phenomena, when light incident on this boundary and after striking this boundary again bounce back to the same medium, or due to which obtain the reflected ray, this phenomena of light is known as reflection. Okay, and due to which the light transmitted to the other medium or we get the refracted ray is known as refraction. Okay. So whenever a light incident on a boundary which separate two medium, these two phenomena occur. But maybe the reflection dominate in some case, maybe the refraction dominate in some case. But depending upon the nature of the medium or the boundary, maybe there is reflection is dominant or maybe there is refraction is dominant. Okay. But when the light return back to the same medium, the phenomena of the light is known as reflection. When the light transmit to the other medium, the phenomena is known as refraction. So here we are going to deal with the phenomena which is known as reflection. That means if the incident ray return back to the same medium after striking the boundary, what will happen? Next we will go for the phenomena which is known as refraction if the ray transmit to the other medium. But in general, when a ray is incident on a boundary which is separate two medium, these two phenomena occur simultaneously. But depending upon the nature of this boundary, maybe the reflection is dominant, maybe the refraction is dominant. In which case the reflection is dominant, that is known as reflection. In which case refraction is dominant, that is known as refraction. But generally these two occur simultaneously. Clear? So to
Now we are going to discuss about only the case of reflection. That means if the light ray is incident, it is returned back to the same medium. Clear? So what is reflection? So as we already started here, reflection. It is the phenomena due to which the incident light bounces back to the same medium. Okay, it is the phenomena due to which the incident light bounces back to the same medium after being obstructed by boundary. Okay, so this is the phenomena due to which the incident light bounces back to the same medium after being obstructed by a boundary is known as reflection. Clear? So again, reflection is divided into two types. Which are two types? Regular is regular reflection. If the reflecting surface is smooth like a plane mirror, okay, then the reflection is regular. Here the reflected rays travels in a particular direction. Okay, like this. If this is a smooth reflecting surface, so when light incident at this surface, like this, after reflection they travel in a particular direction. Okay, so this is regular reflection. What is irregular reflection? If the reflecting surface is rough, okay, if the reflecting surface is rough, then the reflection will be irregular reflection, like this. If the surface will be like this, rough surface. So when light incident on this surface, they travel in random direction. Okay, so this type of reflection, when after reflection the reflected rays travel in random direction, the reflection is known as irregular reflection. Clear? So reflection is of two types depending upon the reflecting surface. If the reflecting surface is smooth, the reflection is regular, or the reflected ray travels in a particular direction. If the reflecting surface is not smooth, then the reflection is irregular reflection, and after the reflection the reflected ray travels in different directions or random directions. Clear? So you already studied that what is reflection and what are the types of reflection. So now we are going to study about the laws of reflection in electrical optics. What is the laws of reflection? Okay, so if this is a reflecting surface, the surface from which light gets reflected, that means
after bouncing at this surface, the light again return back to the same medium, which is known as reflection. So it is a reflecting surface, and this is the incident light ray, which is incident on this surface. Let this is the PS. So PS is the incident light ray, and this is the normal or the perpendicular drawn at the point of incidence on the reflecting surface. And after reflection, the ray again return back to the same medium. So let this will be the SR, be the reflected ray. Clear? And this is NS, is known as normal. Clear? So in this figure, this surface is known as reflecting surface. Okay. So here you can write, this is known as reflecting surface. Okay, this is known as incident ray. This is known as reflected ray. Okay, and this is known as normal at point of incidence. Okay, and this angle, the angle which made by the incident ray with the normal is denoted by I, which is known as angle of incidence. And the angle which made the reflected ray with the normal is denoted by R, which is known as angle of reflection. Okay. So the surface from which the incident ray get reflected is known as reflecting surface. It may be any smooth surface, reflecting surface, maybe a plane mirror, maybe a glass, or maybe any smooth surface from which the light gets reflected is known as a reflecting surface. And the perpendicular which drawn at the point of incidence, where the incident ray strikes the reflecting surface, is known as the normal at the point of incidence. And the ray which gets reflected after reflection from this reflecting surface is known as reflected ray. And the angle made by the incident ray with the normal is known as angle of incidence, which is denoted by I generally. And the angle which made by the reflected ray with the normal, which is denoted by R generally, is known as angle of reflection. And the ray and the angle, this one, let it be denoted by phi. Okay, this angle phi, which makes the incident ray with the plane of the reflecting surface, is known as glancing angle. Okay, the angle made by the incident ray with the plane of reflecting surface is known as glancing angle. And this angle by which the incident ray gets rotated or deviated from its initial path, this is the initial path of the incident ray. If there is no reflecting surface, the incident ray will travel along this direction. So this will be the initial path of the incident ray, but due to this reflecting surface, the after reflection, the incident ray travels along this direction as reflected ray. So the incident ray rotated by an angle this much from its initial path to the final path of the reflected ray. So this angle is denoted by delta, which is known as angle of deviation. Okay, so what is glancing angle? The angle made by the incident ray with the plane of the reflecting surface. What is angle of deviation? The angle by which the incident ray gets deviated or gets rotated after reflection from its initial path. So this complete angle is known as angle of deviation. Clear? So in reflection phenomena, we have deals with all these terms, that is what is incident ray, what is reflected ray, what is angle of incidence, what is angle of reflection, what is glancing angle, and what is angle of deviation. Clear? So what are the laws of reflection? So there are two laws. First law, the incident ray reflected ray and normal at point of incidence lies on same plane. If this is the reflecting surface, okay, the incident ray, the normal and the reflected ray all lies on the same plane of this board. So this plane itself, clear, they all lies in, this is taken as y axis and this is taken as x axis. So all these planes will lies along what? If this is incident ray, this is reflected ray. So all these rays lie along the xy plane. Clear? Okay. So the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal at point of incidence O all lies in the same plane. This is known as the first law of reflection. Then what is second law? The angle of incidence that is denoted by I is equal, this is I, is equal to the angle of reflection R. Okay, the angle of incidence is equal to what? The angle of reflection R. Okay, so these are the two laws of reflection. The first law states that the incident ray, the normal and the reflected ray all lies on the same plane, and the second law states that the angle of incidence and angle of reflection are equal to each other. Okay, so next we will discuss about how image formed by plane mirror. What is a plane mirror? So plane mirror, plane mirror, it is a smooth glass. Glass plate having a opaque coating behind it. Okay, a smooth glass plate having a opaque coating behind it can behave as a plane mirror. So if here is a plane mirror which is smooth and flat and have a opaque coating behind it, so if light incident on this mirror, it will get reflected completely. And according to the law of reflection, if this angle is I, this angle is R, so I must be equal to R. This is known as angle of incidence, this is angle of reflection, and this is the normal at point of incidence. So according to law of reflection, these three remain in the same plane, and this angle must be equal to this angle. Clear? So what are the characteristics of a plane mirror? So what is a plane mirror? Plane mirror basically a smooth plane glass plate which have one side coated with a opaque medium or opaque substance. Clear? So what are the characteristics of a plane mirror? So or how image is formed in a plane mirror? So in geometrical optics, before that we have to study what is an object and image. So in geometrical optics, what is an object? So it is the point where all incident rays are converging or appears to diverge from okay. So object is a point in geometrical optics. Object is a point where all incident rays are converging or appears to diverge from. So if the incident rays are converging at this point, so this point will be the object. Or if the incident rays are diverging from this point, this is known as object. Okay, if the incident rays are converging
or in the incident rays are diverging from the point is known as what? Object. Clear? Similarly, what is the image? So it is the point where all the reflected rays are converging or appear to diverge from. Okay, so the image is a point where all the rays are reflected rays or converging or appear to diverge from. So if this is a reflecting surface, this is the object, the incident rays are diverging from this point, and after reflection they travel like this, and these rays are appear to diverge from this point. So this point will be the image. Okay, so in ray optics, image is the point where all the reflected rays are appear to diverge from, or in real, if the reflected rays after reflection converge at this point, then this point is also known as image. Clear? So what is an image or object in geometrical optics? Clear? So next, how image is formed? By using a plane mirror. So what are the characteristics of a plane mirror? So how, first of all, we have to discuss how an image is formed in case of a plane mirror. So if this is a plane mirror, so we already discussed in geometrical optics, an object is a point from where all the incident rays are diverging or appear to diverging from or converging. So if here is an object and an incident ray is start from here along this direction and another one is start along this direction. So as it is an object, it emits incident ray from all directions, but for my convenience, I am considering only two rays. So as this is the plane mirror, so after reflection, these two rays gets bounce back along the same direction. So if at this point of object, a incidence, I am drawing a normal. So after reflection, this incident ray will travel along this direction. So as if this is the angle of incidence I1, this will be the angle of reflection R1, and according to the law of reflection, these two angles will be same. Similarly, if this is an incident, another incident ray which is acting or incident on the plane mirror normally in 90 degree angle. So if I am drawing a normal here, the angle between normal and the incident ray itself will be zero. So the reflecting angle will be with the normal will be zero. So again the incident ray after reflection travel along the same path, because this is also the normal. So the angle between incident ray and normal is zero. So according to law of reflection, the angle between reflected ray and normal is have to be zero. So the reflected ray travel along the same path as that of the incident ray. So if at these two points, I am extending these two reflected rays, because in geometrical optics, what is image? Image is the point where all the reflected ray converge, or the point where all the reflected ray diverge or appear to converge or appear to diverge from. So as the reflected ray R2 here is traveling along this direction and the reflected ray R1 is traveling along this direction, so if I am extending these two, they are appear to diverge from this point. Clear? So this will be the image of this object, which is a point object. So this will be the point image. So object is the point where the incident ray are appear to diverge from, and image is the point where the reflected rays are appear to diverge from, or reflected rays are actually diverge from that point, or the reflected rays are actually converging at that point. So here in this case, this will be the image of the object O. And as this is the plane mirror and the image lies behind the plane mirror, so here the image will be virtual, because we can touch this image. But as the object is lies in front of the plane mirror, so the object is real. Clear? So in this case, the object is real, the image is virtual. Okay? So this is how the image is formed in case of a plane mirror. So what are the characteristics of a plane mirror?
The image distance. And object distance. You have to remember all these points. The image distance is object distance. From the surface of plane mirror. It's same. That means the distance at which the object is placed from the surface of the plane mirror will be same as that the distance at which the image will appear from the surface of the plane mirror. Next, the object size and image size are same. Size are always same. Okay, then the object is always erect, the image is always erect. Always erect with respect to object. But it only reverses laterally. Okay, what does it mean? If in front of a plane mirror there is an object which is named as A and B, the image will be appear same as that of the object A and B. It is not inverted, it is erect. But if in front of a plane mirror I am writing a letter P which appear as this, this is the object, the image will be laterally reversed or inverted. That means the image will be like this. So the object and image are laterally reversed or inverted, but they are erect to each other. That means there will be no change in their erection, or if it is straight, it will remain straight. Clear? So next characteristics. The object and image formed by a plane mirror are always opposite in nature. That means if object is real, image is virtual. And if image is real, object is virtual. Clear? Next, the image formation of an object in a plane mirror is independent of size of mirror. Okay, so these are basically some characteristics of a plane mirror. So we are already discussed what is reflection, what are the type of reflection, how reflect, what are the laws of reflection, how reflection takes place, and what is a plane mirror, and what are the characteristics of a plane mirror. So next class we will discuss further. Okay, thank you.